the actual size of the entrance that we had to crawl through. I'm gonna show you, I'm gonna demonstrate, but it's not gonna be pretty. I don't even know, I think I'm gonna do
Here are my 15 favorite things to do in South Africa, presented by Melly Telly. South Africa is a beautiful country on the southernmost tip of the African continent. There it has mountains, lush winelands, cliffs, beaches, forests, oh, and let's not forget about the crazy wildlife. In the Western Cape, you will find the Cango Caves.
This is the actual size of volcanoes that we had to crawl through. I'm going to show you here, I'm going to demonstrate, but it's not going to be pretty. I think I'm gonna do these. And then there's more. Follow me. We also have to go through a tunnel like this. Not as bad, but it's a long way. We did it, and oh, it's pretty easy now after what I just did, but legit, actual size.
Take a guided tour climbing and crawling through narrow passages. But be careful. Our guide told us the story of a tourist that was stuck for hours. Cave paintings indicate that the caves were actually used during the Stone Ages.
We survived the cave adventure in South Africa. We did it. It was pretty intense. We had to crawl up a lot, slide down, and the rock is like this close to you, walk sideways, but it was really fun.
If you have good weather, the first thing you should do is take the cableway or hike up to the very top of Table Mountain. This tourist attraction is a flat top mountain overlooking Cape Town.
I'm at the top of Table Mountain in Cape Town, South Africa. It's over 1,000 meters high, which is about 3,300 feet, so it's pretty high and flat up top. It is also officially one of the new 7 wonders of nature of the world, with an incredible view. Check it out.
I recommend to purchase your tickets online. You can even do that while you're waiting in line. The adorable Dassy can be found all over the mountain, and it will allow people to get pretty close. Fun fact, they are also related to the elephant. But if that wasn't enough, there's a large variety of fauna and flora. Stay on top of the mountain a bit later so you can witness the beautiful sunset. But I warn you, the lineup will be very long to go back down. Get up really early like us and go for a safari game drive. We went to Addo National Elephant Park near Port Elizabeth. It is actually the third largest national park in South Africa. The park has about 120,000 visitors annually, and you can also camp out overnight. The park was originally founded in 1931 in order to provide a sanctuary for the elephants in the area. It now houses 700 elephants, along with a large number of other animals. We were so lucky to see so many elephants by the water. Sit on a cliff and watch whales all day from June to December. At the end of September, you can celebrate the mating season at the festivities of the annual whale festival. We saw so many whales, we couldn't even keep count. Drive over to Betty's Bay to visit the adorable African penguin colony at Stony Point Nature Reserve.
So many penguins! So cute! You're not supposed to feed them. Don't bite. They're adorable.
Walk along the boardwalk to observe the penguins go about their daily activities in their natural habitat.
Please explain.
They said they all got the memo to wear the little suit, their little tuxedos.
Opening hours are 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., but the best time to visit is actually either early in the morning or late in the day. Walk with, feed, hug, and pet the elephants at Buffelsdrift. None of these elephants were taken from the wild for captivity, but instead they were orphaned by poachers and then rescued. As you can see, we were there on a very rainy, muddy day, but that just added to the experience, and the animals really seemed to enjoy it. The elephants were super friendly and wanted to play in the water more than anything else. This was such a great experience and I totally recommend it. Baboons are everywhere.
It's pretty common in South Africa to find baboons on the side of the road. And there are some, and there are babies. So we're gonna go check them out. And I'm so excited, but we're gonna keep a distance because you have to be careful. But look at them.
Luckily, the ones we found were not aggressive. Although adorable, these large creatures should be viewed from a distance, or maybe just stay in your car. Cape Town is filled with lots of history and statues, including the Rhodes statue from 1908, which is now being campaigned for removal, and someone already tried to cut it down. High Court was once used to determine race classification and citizenship. This sad act was only 50 years ago, and remnants are still seen today as a reminder of the dark times. Get a workout at Storms River Suspension Bridges. They span 77 meters and are a big tourist attraction. It was originally built in 1969, but don't worry, it has since been rebuilt to ensure safety. To get there, you do have to do a bit of a hike and they are a bit wobbly, but it's lots of fun. At 260 meters, this bridge is one of the world's highest bungee jumps. Face your fear, get a rush of adrenaline, and jump over the river. Or just watch somebody else do it. Go ziplining over waterfalls and between 700-year-old yellowwood trees. This was my first time ziplining, and I would do it again in a heartbeat. Be in two places at once where the Atlantic and Indian Ocean meet. This is the most southern tip of South Africa and is beautiful at sunset. You can even put your fingers in the water where the oceans meet.
Whoa. Oh, man.
Get a neck massage by world's largest bird at an ostrich farm. For more on this, watch my full-length video with highlights from our trip to the farm. Now my favorite, wine tasting. Stellenbosch is the wine region of South Africa, so the surrounding area has many vineyards, which means ample opportunity to partake in wine tastings. They also have wine and chocolate pairings too. My all-time favorite excursion was shark cage diving in Gonse Bay. For more on this, be sure to watch my full-length video to see a shark put its head in the cage. It was crazy. I did get a bit seasick, but you know what? It was worth it. Overall, South Africa is a beautiful country with great food and friendly people. There's lots to see, lots to do, and make sure you get your souvenirs for memories for a lifetime.